Okay, so today I'm going to talk about mushroom poisoning. First, we look into what is mushroom poisoning. So, mushroom poisoning, or it is also known as mushroom toxicity or mycetism, occurs after the ingestion of mushroom that contains toxins, often in the context of foraging for non-toxic, similarly appearing mushrooms. There are thousands of species of mushrooms, but only about 100 species of mushrooms cause symptoms when eaten by humans. And only 15 to 20 mushroom species are potentially lethal when ingested. So there's no simple rule which exists for distinguishing edible mushrooms from poisonous mushrooms. In more than 95% of mushroom toxicity cases, poisoning occurs as a result of misidentification of the mushroom by an amateur mushroom hunter. So the amateur mushroom hunter thinks that they know what mushroom is poisonous and which is not just by looking at it, because many mushrooms appear similar in shape, size, color, etc. So that is why they take it and they ingest it, and then toxicity or poisoning happens. So the severity of mushroom poisoning may vary depending on these factors, which is geographical location where the mushroom is grown, growth conditions, the amount of toxin delivered, the genetic characteristics of the mushroom, and also boiling, cooking, freezing, or processing may not alter the toxicity of some mushrooms because they might be resistant towards it. Okay, coming to effects, mushroom poisoning can have three major effects: positive, neutral, and negative. In positive, they can cause mood lift, euphoria, increased laughing, may interrupt cluster sequences in those suffering from cluster headaches. Cluster headaches are basically headaches which appear in patterns. The neutral feelings will be feeling more emotionally sensitive, pupil dilation, sleepiness. These are not negative. They don't cause any harm, and at the same time, they don't cause any positive effects. So that is why they are neutral. Then coming to negative feelings, intense feeling of fear, nausea, confusion, mild to severe anxiety, dizziness may be the effects for negative classification. So mushroom poisoning can be classified into the three major categories based on the time from ingestion to the development of the symptoms. So in early symptom category, symptoms generally appear within 6 hours of mushroom ingestion and include GI, allergic, or neurological syndromes. In late symptom category, signs and symptoms begin to appear between 6 to 24 hours after ingestion and may include hepatotoxic, nephrotoxic, and erythromelalgic syndrome. And then there is delayed symptom category, where symptoms appear more than 24 hours after ingestion and include mostly nephrotoxic syndromes. So diagnosis of these can be done by serum test, urine analysis, arterial blood gas analysis, LFT, etc. So this is a label diagram of the mushroom. Generally, identification process takes place by identifying the cap, the scales, and the gills of the mushroom. Okay, now coming to toxins. These are the following toxins which are present in mushroom. I'll describe about them in the next slide. The most common consequence of mushroom poisoning is simply GI upset. So it's not that if you eat a mushroom, all mushrooms are toxic and they'll cause to your death. Some are just they'll just simply cause a GI upset. So most poisonous mushrooms contain GI irritants that cause vomiting and diarrhea, but usually no long-term damage is there. Now coming to their effects and toxicity. So first toxin is alpha amanitin. These are deadly toxins and cause often fatal liver damage 1 to 3 days after ingestion. Principal toxin present in death cap. Death cap is a type of mushroom which is there, which is one of the most lethal mushrooms which is present. Next, coming to phallotoxin, these are non-lethal. So they don't cause immediate death, but they will cause extreme GI upset. And they are found in various mushrooms. Orelanine, these are deadly, cause kidney failure within 3 weeks after ingestion. Principal toxin in genus Cortinarius. Then coming to muscarine, these are potentially deadly. These cause sludge syndrome. I'll explain about the sludge syndrome in the next slide. And these are found in various mushrooms, and its antidote is atropine. And coming to monomethylhydrazine, these are also deadly. They cause brain damage, seizures, GI upset, hemolysis, metabolic poison, and principal toxin in genus Gyromitria. And antidote in larger doses of IV pyridoxine hydrochloride. Next is corpine. These are also non-lethal. So causes illness when consumed with alcohol. Principal toxin in genus Coprinus. Then coming to ibotenic acid. These are potentially deadly. And these are excitotoxin. So excitotoxicity is the pathological process by which nerve cells are damaged or killed by excessive stimulation of neurotransmitters. Then coming to muscimol, these are also potentially deadly and cause CNS depression and hallucinations. Then coming to arabitol, these are also non-lethal and cause diarrhea in some people. And bolacetine, these are also non-lethal and same cause GI irritation like vomiting, nausea, etc. Then coming to ergotamine, these are deadly, affect the vascular system and can lead to loss of limbs and or cardiac arrest. These are found in the genus Claviceps. Okay, Sluts syndrome. So a Sluts syndrome is an overstimulation at a neuromuscular junction due to excess of acetylcholine as a result of inactivity of acetylcholine esterase, which normally breaks down acetylcholine. As a result of cholinergic crisis, the muscles stop responding to the bombardment of acetylcholine, leading to flaccid paralysis, respiratory failure, and other signs and symptoms reminiscent of organophosphate poisoning. Other symptoms include increased sweating, salivation, bronchial secretion, along with meiosis. Okay, now coming to the most lethal mushrooms. These mushrooms can cause death if not treated properly and immediately. So of the most lethal mushrooms, three belong to the genus Amanita. These are the death cap mushrooms, also known as Amanita phalloids, destroying agents, which are Virosa and Bisporigera, and fool's mushroom, that is Varna. And then apart from this, two more are there, which belong to the genus Cotinarius. These are Rubellus and Aurelinus. Okay, so coming to the first mushroom, the death cap mushroom. These are one of the most poisonous mushrooms known to man. It is estimated that even as little as half a mushroom contains enough toxin to kill an adult human. It has been involved in majority of human deaths from mushroom poisoning. The principal toxin constitutes of alpha-amanitin, which damages the liver and kidneys, causing liver and kidney failure that can be fatal. The class of toxin found in these mushrooms are thermostable, that is, they are resistant to change in heat. So cooking this does not cure the poison. Signs and symptoms after ingestion of this death cap mushroom include initial symptoms are GI in nature and include abdominal pain with watery diarrhea, nausea, vomiting, which may lead to dehydration if left untreated, and in severe cases, hypotension, tachycardia, hypoglycemia, and acid-base disturbances. These first symptoms resolve 2 to 3 days after ingestion. A more serious deterioration signifying liver involvement may then occur, which is jaundice, diarrhea, delirium, seizure, and coma due to liver failure caused by accumulation of normally liver removed substances in the blood. So then coming to kidney failure and coagulopathy may also appear during this stage. Life-threatening complications include increased intracranial pressure, intracranial bleeding, pancreatic inflammation, acute kidney failure, and cardiac arrest. Death generally occurs 6 to 16 days after poisoning. Next, coming to destroying angels. The destroying agents and the death cap account for the overwhelming majority of deaths due to mushroom poisoning. The toxin responsible for this is amatoxin, which inhibits RNA polymerase 2 and 3. So symptoms do not appear for 5 to 24 hours, by which time the toxin may already be absorbed and the damage, that is destruction to liver and kidney tissues, will become irreversible. As little as half a mushroom cap can be fatal if the victim is not treated quickly enough. So the signs and symptoms in this are vomiting, cramps, delirium, convulsions, and diarrhea. Now coming to fool's mushroom, these are closely related to other deadly pure white amanitas. And the fool's mushroom is one of the most poisonous mushrooms in the world. Just like death cap, this organism contains a fatal dose of alpha-amanitin, which causes liver failure if not treated immediately. While this mushroom, along with many other deadly and edible fungi, also contains phallotoxins, these phallotoxins are not toxic to humans when ingested, as they are poorly absorbed. So most of them are just eliminated. There are no negative symptoms for eating this fungus until 6 to 24 hours after ingestion. Signs and symptoms of poisoning include: the first symptoms is simple unease, violent cramps and diarrhea follow. On the third day, the same symptoms repeat themselves. But while to many, this may seem like a sign of recovery, most of the time it is simply a sign of the final onset of the symptoms. So a person might think that it is not related to the mushroom, but it is actually the mushroom's toxin which is causing these symptoms. And then after some time, the kidney and liver failure due to amatoxins occur. At this point, drastic measures like transplants need to be taken, or the victim would most likely die. Coming to deadly webcap, this mushroom contains the toxin orelinine, which if eaten destroys the kidney and the liver. So signs and symptoms in this include: the initial symptoms of poisoning are usually delayed by 2 to 3 days, after which flu-like symptoms, headaches and vomiting may occur. Renal failure follows, and if not treated, can result in death. Dialysis and other kidney and liver treatments, if received quickly enough, can usually save the lives of people who eat these dangerous mushrooms. Now coming to fool's webcap, these are deadly poisonous species containing orelinine. If eaten rapidly, becomes concentrated in the kidney. Untreated, it destroys the kidney and damages the liver. Even small amounts can cause severe damage, but is treatable with dialysis and other medication over many weeks if immediately identified and treated. So signs and symptoms in this include, these can take 2 to 3 days to begin and then last up to 3 weeks. So starts with flu-like symptoms, then proceeds to renal failure. That is, the person starts to feel unquenchable thirst, frequent urination, kidney pain, followed by a lack of urinating. Left untreated, these can also be fatal. Now coming to the management, supportive measures. So once a toxin is absorbed, it may potentially be neutralized in the following ways: inhibition of tissue uptake of the toxin, inhibition of metabolic pathways involved in the development of toxin, toxicity, enhanced elimination of the toxin. Specific therapy depends on the presumed toxin ingested. So next, moving on to management, toxin specific managements. So amatoxin poisoning: in addition to intensive airway and aggressive rehydration with fluid therapy, correction of coagulation factors and multiple doses of activated charcoal, a number of therapeutic options for amatoxin poisoning have been proposed. So silymarin is given at 1 gram orally for 4 times daily, or its purified alkaloid silibinin is given IV at 5 mg/kg over 1 hour, followed by 20 mg/kg per day as a constant infusion. Silibinin is thought to interfere with hepatic uptake of alpha amanitin, so early institution of therapy offers the best chance of clinical efficacy. Other recommended therapies for this is IV of benzyl penicillin, which reduces the uptake of amatoxin by hepatocytes. Now coming to gyrometrin poisoning. So gyrometrin is unstable and is easily hydrolyzed to the toxin compound monomethylhydrazine. So monomethylhydrazine acts on the central nervous system and interferes with the normal use and functioning of vitamin B6. Poisoning results in nausea, stomach cramps, diarrhea. With severe poisoning, can result in convulsions, jaundice, or even coma or death. Treatment: seizures may be overcome by infusion of pyridoxine, which is nothing but vitamin B6. And if the patient does not respond to that, they can be given benzodiazepines. So hydrazines also inhibit the transformation of folic acid to tetrafolic acid. Therefore, patients with severe gyrometrin toxicity should receive folinic acid in the active form as a therapy. Coming to muscarine poisoning, humans with muscarine poisoning develop excessive perspiration, lacrimation, and salivation. This together is called as PSL syndrome, within 15 to 30 minutes after ingestion. The combination of these symptoms is diagnostic and is generally seen only with this type of mushroom poisoning. Most patients with poisoning due to mushrooms containing muscarine can be treated without medications. Severe muscarinic symptoms, however, may be treated with infusion of small doses of atropine. The 2 mg atropine auto-injector is intended as an initial treatment of the muscarine symptoms. In muscarine poisoning, the entire episode usually subsides within 6 to 8 hours. Some symptoms, although, may take up to 24 hours to fully resolve. Atropine should be considered only when excessive bronchial secretions compromise breathing and cause shortness of breath. If the patient presents within 1 hour of ingestion, oral administration of activated charcoal may be considered. Administer IV fluids if vomiting becomes prominent. In very severe cases, liver transplantation is the only way to go. So indication for immediate organ liver transplant include the following. Stage 3 hepatic encephalopathy. Serum bilirubin levels are higher than 4.6 mg per deciliter. Prothrombin time or prolongation unresponsive to fresh frozen plasma infusions where the patient with PT is more than 100 seconds should be considered for transplantation. Other suggested factors to consider including the following are age younger than 12 years, serum creatinine levels if they are higher than 1.4 mg per deciliter, hemorrhage, shock, acidosis, hypoglycemia. In patients with these indications, OLT may be the only life-saving therapy. So finally, I have referred the question bank and these are the 2-mark questions. I have answered these in the slide, so you can just go through it. And as a summary, just don't eat mushrooms without identifying them properly. And if a mushroom poisoning does occur, try to reach the hospital as soon as possible to get the best treatment and be cured. Okay, thank you.
ಇಲ್ಲದ್ರೆ ಫೋನ್ ಬರ್ತಾರ ಇಲ್ಲದ್ರೆ